Everyone, welcome to this video series on Java threads. And in today's video, we will see what is a process, what is a thread, what is the difference between a process and a thread, and what is multitasking and the types of multitasking. So let's start with what is a process. So a process can be called as an independent program which is in execution. For example, consider an application which is a Microsoft Word application that is installed in our computer. So whenever we double click on the Microsoft Word icon, the program gets loaded into the main memory or the RAM, and the CPU starts executing that program. So when the CPU starts executing the program, it becomes a process. So earlier it was a program, and when the CPU starts executing it, it became a process. Let me show you an example in my task manager. So here is my task manager, and I have currently three applications which is open, and let's open, these are all the processes that are currently running in my system. So let's open the Mozilla Firefox. So whenever I open Mozilla Firefox, you can see the program starts executing, which forms a process. So the Firefox, which was earlier only the program, when the CPU was allocated to the program and the CPU starts executing it, it became a process. And when I just close this, it is gone. So this is what a process is. Then what is a thread? So a thread can be called as an independent path of execution within a program or a process. So a thread can be called as a part of a process. So suppose you have a huge process and there are various parts in that process or various subtasks in that process which can be called as a thread. For example, consider the Microsoft Word application. In the Microsoft Word application, when you type some text, at the same time the spell check is running on as well as the autocorrect is running on. So the spell check can be called as a thread. The autocorrect can also be called as a thread. So these both the threads are a part of a huge application or a huge process, which is the Microsoft Word application. Same is demonstrated in the diagram. You have a huge, the bigger circle is the Microsoft Word, and the threads T1, T2 and T3 are the different parts of the bigger process, which can be spell check in Microsoft Word or the autocorrect or something else. So that is what a thread is. So what's the difference between a process and a thread? So process is very heavyweight, where while a thread is a lightweight. So a process can be called as a bigger program which is in execution, and the thread can be called as the part of that bigger program or the part of that process which is in execution. Process, since they are huge, so they take more time for creation, termination, as well as the context switching. The also process, they don't share the resources. They have own memory space and they have own system resources. While since multiple threads are a part of the same process, so they can share the same memory space. So what is multitasking and what are the types of multitasking? So multitasking, as the name suggests, is multiple tasks can be executed at the same time. For example, you are running a music player in the background, as well as you are trying to play games at the same time. So you can do it. So that is the multitasking. So there are two types of multitasking. The first one is the process-based multitasking, and the second one is a thread-based multitasking. So process-based multitasking is multiple processes are running simultaneously. For example, you can play music in the background as well as you can download the files from the internet at the same time. The thread-based multitasking is multiple threads are running at the same time simultaneously. For example, a Microsoft Word application, you can type the text at the same time, as well as the multiple threads like the autocorrect, the spell check, both are running simultaneously. Also, the process-based multitasking is at the OS level, while the thread-based multitasking is at the programmatic level. So that's all for this video. If you have any questions, kindly put the questions in the comment section below. And thanks for watching, and kindly subscribe and share with other people so that they can also learn, and keep and please press the bell icon for getting more update on my videos. Thank you everyone. Bye bye.